Dear all, welcome to this tutorial. Let's discover together how to edit your videos with Apple iMovie 2021. After this short video, you will be able to realize your first video project, importing media, applying effects, and great pieces of text. iMovie includes all the features you need to manage your media and make your own video. You can download it for free from the App Store. When you open iMovie, this opens on the Projects page, showing the complete list of your iMovie projects saved. You can manage, delete, or open these to start editing again. You also have the Media page to organize your media files into custom iMovie libraries. To start from a new project, go to Create New, then choose Trailer to pick a ready film-like template to use, or Movie to make your own video starting from your media files. We will go for this. At this point, the new project opens completely empty. You can come back to the Projects page with its button in the top left corner after defining a name for the current project that will be added into the projects list. At this point, you have to import all the videos, images, and sound files to use into the timeline at the bottom. To do so, you can drag and drop these from Finder directly into the timeline or from any existing iMovie library under the My Media panel. You can also get extra samples under Audio and great images under Backgrounds. You can also record from your microphone using Record VoiceOver. Set Source, Volume Level, and then go to Start Recording. Using the stop button to finish. The timeline is the place where you edit and work with your files to realize the final video. All files imported are shown as blocks called clips and all listed under Project Media inside My Media. All visual frames are represented with their thumbnails, whereas audio files show their sound waveform in blue color on videos and in green color on sound files. Use the slider on the right to adjust the zoom level over these. You can use the video preview to check the timeline content, hiding the media library to enlarge it. Hover over your clips to check these through time, and use the spacebar key to play and stop the playback. This follows the main marker on the timeline. iMovie also adds automatic zooms on all imported pictures by default. All these clips are collected on several rows called tracks, such as maximum 2 video tracks for video frames and pictures, and unlimited audio tracks for sound and speech. The most important track is the main video track with a dark marker at the beginning. This collects the main project content where clips are placed sequentially in time without any empty time gap. The other video track on top contains all the visual clips that must be placed in front of all the clips within the main video track, allowing time gaps as well. Below the main video track, you get all the audio tracks, plus a separated one at the bottom used to include any background music. Now, let's see how to edit the timeline clips. To move any clip in time, just click and drag it. If you move any clip on the top video track or on any audio track, this gets linked to the main clip it overlaps in time. This way, when you move the main clip in time, also all the visual and audio clips linked to it follow. Whereas, if you need to extract and manage the audio content of any video, right-click on it and go to Detach Audio. Remember to use Command and Z to undo any action if you make any mistake. To trim clips in time, drag from their edges. This removes content in case of video and audio clips. To stretch and shorten in time without affecting content, you can adjust their speed rate by right-clicking and going to Show Speed Editor. Then, you can use the marker on top to increase the clip length and make it slower, or decrease it to make it faster, with either a turtle or a heap icon on the clip itself. To cut, copy, and paste any clip, click on it to select it and use Command and X, C or V. You can also cut limited portions from the clip by holding down the R key and clicking and dragging on it, using Command and X to cut. Whereas, to split any clip in multiple pieces, place the main marker, right-click on it, and go to Split Clip. On audio clips, you can pull up and down the envelope line to adjust its volume level uniformly. Make sure not to get red levels to avoid any distortion. With iMovie, you can also add transitions to start or end clips with nice effects. You can add smooth transitions by dragging from the corners of visual and audio clips, changing either the opacity or the volume level in time. To add transitions between the clips inside the main video track, drag and drop any from the Transitions panel. You can drag another to change the effect to use and adjust the transition length and speed by double-clicking on its symbol. iMovie includes several tools to adjust your clips above the preview. On visual clips, you can open Color Balance to adjust colors, taking as reference any frame or any point from the clip itself. Or Color Correction to adjust brightness, contrast, saturation, and temperature levels. With cropping, you can select Crop to Fill to crop the clip keeping its aspect ratio, or Kin Burns to apply a great zoom effect by moving and resizing the start and the end rectangles on the preview. You can also use the rotate buttons to rotate the clip by 90 degrees. With Clip Filter, you can apply special visual and audio effects, choosing from the list. If you select any clip placed on a top video track, you also get the video overlay settings that include all the options to manage how the clip shall overlap on the main content. Use Cutaway to adjust the transparency level. Green-blue screen to remove any green or blue color from the clip and make these regions fully transparent. And split screen to show both the top clip and the main one below it. Whereas, with picture-in-picture, you can place the current clip over the main video directly on the preview, dragging it to place it, and using its nodes to scale and resize it. You can also apply borders or shadow if necessary. If you select audio clips, you can open volume to adjust the volume level, and noise reduction and equalizer to remove noise and apply audio templates to adjust the audio spectrum. iMovie includes several text templates inside the Titles panel of the Media Library. Get a quick preview on any text by hovering over its thumbnail and import it by dragging and dropping it on the timeline. This creates a violet text clip that can be moved and edited just like the other clips. If you add text on the main video track, this gets a black background. Whereas, if you place it above any clip, it gets a transparent background showing what's behind it. Then, double-click on the preview to type in and use the options above to adjust font style, size, color, distribution, and much more. While you work on your project, iMovie saves it automatically. When you are ready to export the final video, go to the Share button in the top right corner. You can either choose ready templates for YouTube, Facebook, and Vimeo, or your own options with Export File. Here, set what to export, the video resolution up to 1080p HD, and the quality and compression levels. Then, define the video name, where to export it, and start rendering with Save. This goes on the background, showing its progress in the top right corner. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Visit our YouTube channel to discover more extra tips and guides completely for free.